The main characters in any given story are ones that I'm invested in and I like, because if they aren't, why am I writing this story? If I don't like them because they make me mad because of the actions they're taking in the story, then that's good, because that engages the reader and the reader's like, oh, I hate that guy. That's good. Hi, I'm Andy Weir, author of The Martian. What are the important parts of a good story? Oh boy, for the sorts of fiction that I write, the most important thing is you need to have a likable protagonist. The reader has to really be rooting for, empathizing with, or even putting themselves into the place of the protagonist.
I'm definitely gonna die up here if I have to listen to any more god-awful disco music.
Number two is it has to pull the reader along. You have to make the reader want to read the next page. I want to keep my readers up all night. I want them to be the sort of person who usually goes to bed at 10 p.m., but they're up until 2 a.m. reading because they just could not put the book down. And in the end, of course, you need to have a satisfying ending. The story needs to end in a way that makes them happy or makes them feel like, yes, that's appropriate. Because once they're done with the book, it's going to stay with them for a little while if you did your job right. If you don't make the ending good, it's going to sour their whole experience. The main characters in any given story are ones that I'm invested in and I like, because if they aren't, why am I writing this story? If I don't like them, I should analyze why I don't like them. If I don't like them because they're boring or it's a chore to read or whatever, then that's something I should address. If I don't like them because they make me mad because of the actions they're taking in the story, then that's good because that engages the reader and the reader's like, oh, I hate that guy. That's good. I consider my biggest weakness as a writer to be characters. My main character in my books will often have some amount of depth. The secondary characters will often be fairly flat. And so, if there's a character I don't like, they just won't get that much screen time. If there's somebody who's important and critical, but really they're just there to exposition one thing, then they have their moment in the sun and then they're gone. I've been trying to get better at that. I'm always working on that. I want to get better. If you want to be a writer, I have three bits of advice for you. First off, you have to actually write. Daydreaming about what your story is going to be like and how cool it's going to be and thinking about one scene or another in your head is not writing. That's daydreaming. It's important, but you need to have words going onto the document in order for you to write. Number two, this is hard, resist the urge to tell your story to your friends and family. Most writers are driven by a desire to have an audience. They want other people to experience the story that they have come up with. If you tell people the story verbally, it takes care of that need and it gets rid of your desire to actually write it. Now you can give it to them a chunk at a time. You don't have to write a whole book before you show it to a friend of yours, but you could write a chapter and say, hey, what do you think of this? Read it, tell me what you think. And then finally, once you've finished your book, there has never been a better time in human history to self-publish. If you want to write a book, and the worst that happens is you spent a lot of time working on something that people didn't like. You have to write a lot before you start writing stuff that is good.
Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.